the journey is the goal. It's not the destination. I carry a lot of gear in Dottie, but I have this day pack that I use for going to the hotel each day. It's got toiletries, change of clothes, and 12 hours of food, and my workout gear. So what I do when I get to the airport, I pull out this pack and I either walk with it or use it when I bike. Now I choose small towns with little airports because this is what it's like when I walk to and from the hotel. It's gorgeous. And my rule of thumb is if it's less than an hour and a half walk, I'll walk to and from the airport. Otherwise, I'll get out my bike and bike to and from the airport. The reason I don't do it all the time is it takes about half an hour to put the bike together and put it away. It's just a hassle. And I'd rather spend that time exercising. The change of clothes in my pack is really only in case it's raining and I get soaked. Because what I do every day when I get to the hotel is I wash all the clothes I'm wearing in the sink, do the towel dance to dry them, and then put them back on until they're completely dry. That way I don't even have to undo my spare clothes if I don't need them. So here's what a typical day is like for me when I'm touring with Dottie. I'll set my alarm for about 4:30. I'll get up and make myself a cup of coffee using my portable tea kettle and instant coffee. And then I will do a weather briefing. Now from the night before, I have a pretty good idea of the direction I want to go. But in the morning, I do the final flight planning to make sure everything is okay. That takes about an hour. Then I make oatmeal with protein powder for breakfast, shower, pack, and start my walk or bike to the airport. On the way, I do additional weather checks, make sure everything's okay. Then arriving at Dottie, I pre-flight Dottie, get everything packed.
When flying, there's a number of things I need to do before I can play tourist.
Then I fly.
First, I need to scan the horizon for traffic to see and avoid other aircraft. I need to monitor the engine and make sure everything is within limits. I need to scan the gauges to make sure everything is on course.
Now, what I do during the flight depends on the conditions. If it's absolutely flawless, clear conditions, I can play tourist and look out the window and marvel at this amazing planet. But the rest of the time, it is a heavy workload in the cockpit where I'm checking weather, navigating around thunderstorms, checking conditions on the ground, changing my route based on where the visibility and ceiling is best. So a lot of times there is no time to play tourist. It's all safety and operating the airplane. I will land probably every hour just to stretch and go to the bathroom. On a typical day, I'll go about 400 miles, which I go 100 miles an hour, but with all I stop, it takes me probably 8 hours a lot of times. So when I arrive at the airport, I need to secure the aircraft. The first thing I do is tie down both wings and the tail and check the oil and the coolant levels, get my backpack out, secure the electronics, secure the control stick so the control surfaces don't flap in the breeze, and then I lock it up and walk to the hotel, where I will first thing get something to eat and then do my laundry in the sink.
And then every other day I'll do a workout. I'll spend about 45 minutes doing a resistance training workout, either in a gym, if I'm lucky enough to have one in the hotel, or most usually it's just outside under a tree doing bodyweight stuff plus suspension trainer.
And do flight planning for the next day. So I probably go to bed around 8:30 because I'm exhausted. People ask, you know, do you do tour stuff during the day? No, there's no time. The travel is the adventure. The journey is the goal. It's not the destination.